Everybody, Alan here. Now, today I'd like to talk about intention. Sounds a bit like attention. Everyone these days wants to get our attention. Now, stand up straight, attention. Oh, funny, eh? Oh, get our attention. Now, I can sell us this. Buy this, buy that, get your attention. Buy this, buy that, oh, so many things, you get so confused. What, so many things to buy. Or you get your attention for your half in life. Join this political group, or that political group. Become a liberal or a labour. And each join this group, and each group has a group mentality. Oh, we are the best. Oh, we are labour. Oh, we are for jobs. Oh, we are helping the working class. Oh, our way is the best. When you have the liberal, our way is the best. We produce the jobs because we have the brains at the top. We have the commercial enterprise. And we are not so controlling. And the Labour will come back and say, we are not really controlling, but we just have rules and regulations to stop all these stupid activities of the zombies. The zombies who want to make it not fair for the working class. The Labour will come back and say, oh, but our way is better. We make things. Well, the truth of the reality is that all these liberal people and the consumer society makes junk. Junk. Buy this, buy that. Eat this, eat that. Get fat. Whether at McDonald's or whatever, Pizza Hut. Buy this gadget, buy that gadget. Oh my God, this goes on. The consumer society, and it makes everyone rich for a short time, that is. Everyone does get rich for a short time, but as soon as everyone gets saturated with consumer goods, then that model of society is going to crash. And we can see it crashing around us today. Everyone has enough consumer junk. And the Labour side, that they are more interested in education. We want to educate you to be able to work harder and harder. But they still promoting a consumer society. So it's exactly the same. No one wins. It is our intention which is at the heart of things. Do we intend to make ourselves a better person? Or do we intend to follow the crowd, to follow the liberal, to follow the labour? If our intentions are in our heart, then we will. Our intentions are to make ourselves better. We can become better in our lives, better at everything. We become a more rounded person. The path has been, you specialise in this job, you specialise in that job, you become a professional at this. You know bloody nothing about anything else. So that's compartmentalised. Compartmentalised, then the society is easy to control. But if you become an all-rounder, then who can control you? You become more independent, more self-reliant, more smart. You know, it becomes more street aware. You become, you know, it's what's going on now. People are becoming more street aware. What do you think these Occupy movements are about? We want to become more street aware. We realise that the past systems have failed us. But we do not. But the Occupy movements has a tendency for them to be hijacked. To become hijacked by those wanting to promote a communistic agenda. And the communistic agenda is also not the way to go. We must not become communistic, otherwise our motivation goes to zit. And we some lazy buggers and we're sitting on our tap behinds. And it also doesn't work. We have to operate from our hearts, become spiritual from our hearts, and that is our intention. We must go from attention to intention. The attention is on the outside. The intention is on the inside. We must operate from the inside, inside our heart space, with our intentions. Like, for an example, today I intend to win $10 million, for I have entered a $10 million jackpot in the Powerball lottery game in Australia. Whether I win or not remains to be seen, but it is my intention to win. And I put that intention out to the universe. And to pick my numbers, I have contacted my higher aspects of myself, both the male and the female aspects. And I have ascertained the numbers which I think will come out most closely. They might not come out. I might only get the vision 5 or something, but whatever I get, I will be happy, because it is my intention. Intention really works on the soul level. It doesn't really work on our bodily level as much. But if our bodily level is connected to our soul level, then more of our intentions will come out. So it's on the soul level which our intentions come out. When we are ignorant of how the universe works, then our intentions still come out. Why? Because everything operates from a soul level. When I was 18, I had a car crash. Of course, on the bodily level, it was not my intention to have a crash, but on the soul level, it was. It was a crash arranged, I'm told, by the ancients. They arranged this car crash. I was in a coma for 21 days. So that's why my speech is slightly off. I don't speak quite the same as the average citizen, which is really a blessing for me. I do not connect with the common people. I connect with the more spiritual people, the ones who I can see within my heart. That is my intention. My intention to become spiritual, so that I operate from my heart space. My intention is that for those around me to also become spiritual, so they also operate within their heart space. And those around me, I include as the whole of the human race. The whole of the human race. That is my intention. My intention is placed upon the whole of the human race, for you to operate within your heart space. You are to remove yourself from the stomach space, the space of the commas, that's what the stomach space is, and to proceed into the heart space. Feel the energy behind my words. For coming from me are angels and higher beings who are forming a foundation energy within the whole earth. And it is my intention to make the whole earth a spiritual place. If everyone has their intention in parallel with mine, then the earth will become spiritual very fast. Now, the Occupy movements don't become sidetracked by people who want to hijack them. They set their intention within their heart space, then everything is rosy, rosy. I have spoken enough for now. 9 minutes is probably enough. So I bid you farewell and wish you all the best. My love to you, and my love is in you. Thank you very much for listening to my talk today. Thank you. Bye-bye, 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 bye-bye.